4th of September today, and this is the most uncanny thing ever. Just, I think my hair might be coming out. If you just hold on to it and just pull, and you end up with this. Bye, hair. So the dilemma when your hair starts falling out is, do you shave it off or do you just leave it until it all falls out? I think that you shave it off, because if your hair gets stuck in your hairbrush and you have a knot, you give yourself a bald patch. And the bathroom doesn't look very pretty after you've finished. Yeah, I think it's time to shave it off. Look at it, her face.
You know, I look terrible. You're getting it from the wrong angle. I've got double chins.
So do I. 20 of them. So Bex has always wanted to do this.
I'm doing a number one.
Yep. I always wanted to do a random shave down the middle. Quite a cool hairstyle.
Oh yeah.
Look at my bald patch.
You did it. I was not responsible for that.
Right, do I look really cool?
It's so beautiful, so you can wear that in a big towel that way, and you can wear it in a big towel that way.
I don't think so. Okay. A reverse mohawk. I absolutely hate how easily my hair is falling out, and it drives me mental, itching, and so my new way of waxing. Can you see that? Hang on, here you go. I want it all gone. It's driving me mental.
I love you, Mom. I love you, Mum, and I love you so much and the whole world.
Good night. Love you. See you in the morning.
I love you.
Love you.
When are you going to come back? Excuse yours, Nathan.
Love you.
Good morning, Mum. I hope you're feeling better.
Good morning, Mom. I hope you're feeling better. And I hope you have a good morning.
I love you.
And I hope you're feeling better. I miss you.
I love you too.
Hi, my name is Claire Marie Turner. I'm 43 years old. I have been diagnosed with triple positive breast cancer. I'm undergoing chemotherapy for 12 weeks of AC and 12 weeks of another lot of drugs, and then I'll undergo surgery and possibly radiation. And this is my story. So chemo day, I wake up, I'm actually starting to feel sick already. From the minute I wake up on chemo day, knowing that it's going to start all over again. So I normally it's between 10:30 and 12 when I have to go into chemo. Bex always takes me, so my friend takes me, and she dropped me off this time. And so I go in, I sit down, they hook me up in my port because my veins are so bad. Yet another thing that they don't necessarily tell you about, that you have to have this horrid thing with more scars stuck in you if your veins don't work. So that makes it easier to administer the chemo now. You can taste it in your mouth. Your taste buds disappear. You start feeling a little bit off and woozy and sick. And then once it's, they just unhook you once you're done. Unhook you, flush the port out, tape me up, and off I go home. I get home and I just make sure everything's done because I know it's going to hit within 4 hours. So I have a shower and I get ready for bed, and I make sure the dinner's done, kids are set up, everything's done before the grossness starts. And you know that it's going to start, and then you just go downhill from there for probably, mine seems to be 8 days, where I feel pretty miserable. I think I might have been a bit different to other people because I went in it thinking that I was going to be fine, that this was going to be a breeze, that I was just going to get on with it, and I would deal with feeling sick, and I knew it was coming and I was just going to deal with it. It wasn't until that first time when I realised that I couldn't deal with it, that this is hard. And there goes the tears, you see. I realised that actually this is worse than I thought it was going to be. So I think going in with it, they say be positive and have a good attitude and you'll beat it and stuff. I did. I didn't even think that anything was going to be a problem. But the more you go on, the more you feel like this, the sicker you feel, you start having questions and you start worrying about stuff. And I didn't even think about dying, now I do. I'm terrified. Terrified.
Thank you. It's me, Nathan, speaking, and today I hope you're going to be feeling well, and I hope the chemo treatment goes well. So, love from me, Nathan Turner. I love you, Mum.
So, I'm back home, and I'm just about to eat dinner.
Get more better. So see you next time. Bye.